steam.
That big sweet actress, I see right through it.
No problem.
But who could blame her? The bullshit on the bill truly got out of hand, closing odds on Rousey with the favourite being set at -2,000. Rousey's coach, Edmund Talberdian, had been spouting nonsense about Rousey's potential to outfox everyone, including the male 135-pound division.
She's knocking out the guys.
To the point where Rousey seemed so untouchable that media outlets genuinely entertained the idea of Mayweather-Rousey.
I wonder how Floyd feels being beat by a woman for once.
So with all that nonsense, surrounded by a legion of yes-men, with even Joe Rogan himself adding fuel to the fire, why couldn't Rousey think she could stand with a multiple world boxing champion and win?
There's a lot of guys her size she could beat. You took the roster of the UFC's bantamweight, 135 pounds, and you paired them up against Ronda Rousey. She might be able to beat 50% of them.
And so the stage and ultimately burial site was set in front of a record-breaking 56,214 people in attendance, with millions of people watching around the world. And at the opening bell, Rousey bounced forward with all the arrogance of a prize goat on show day, showing absolutely no respect for Hahn's striking abilities. Rousey pushed the pressure on an outstanding counter-striker in Hahn and seriously paid for it, being caught coming in multiple times in the first round.
It takes a lot of energy to be a rock star.
Now Holly's taking a lot.
Between rounds, Rousey's coach tells her she's doing a beautiful job, and you can almost hear the bell tolls. In the second round, Holm showed much the same, even ducking a wild swinging hook before executing the head kick kill switch to end the fight in spectacular fashion. The domination in this fight was clear, probably avoidable, but ultimately one of the cleanest demonstrations of a champion destruction. And number one, Anderson Silva versus Rich Franklin. Anderson Silva versus Rich Franklin comes in at number one for multiple reasons. A heavy factor in this is the nature in which Franklin was putting people away prior to meeting Silva at UFC 64. He was on an 8-fight winning streak, won and then defended the middleweight championship twice, including one of the most spectacular highlight reel finishes of Nate Quarry at UFC 56. He was also a dream poster boy for the UFC, holding a master's degree in mathematics and previously teaching mathematics at Oak Hills High School in Cincinnati. Franklin spoke elegantly about the sport, unlike many fighters of the time, and truly emphasized what the UFC needed most of the time, a true relatable ambassador for a widely criticized sport. Therefore, when Anderson Silva arrived on the scene to challenge Franklin after a dominant dispatch of Chris Lieben, many believed that although this would be Franklin's first real test, he had it in the bag, entering the octagon as a -185 favorite.
Resident Evil.
As multifaceted as Franklin was as a mixed martial artist at the time, he had absolutely no answer for the tight clinch that Silva clutched him into, unleashing a magnitude of vicious means to Franklin.
What am I going to do? What am I going to say? Bim 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 bim.
Title.
Okay. You gonna kiss a nigga and then be like, don't worry about me. Is it a typewriter? No. Oh shit.
Sure to follow us at all.
fighter that one would just completely dominate. Despite everything pointing to that matchup going a certain way, no matter the logic of skill set, records, and overall ability, the opposite somehow happens. Essentially, what I'm talking about is MMA math. The person who logically should win somehow gets a tie. Legends of the champions who held their titles for hundreds of days, building up a collection of title defenses that made them staples of their divisions and even the sport itself. Through these reigns, iconic moments were crafted that will live forever. I'm Tom from MMA on Point, and this is 10 longest UFC title reigns. Number 10, Joanna Jędrzejczyk, 966 days. So up at number 10 is the self-proclaimed strawweight queen, Joanna Jędrzejczyk, who is just shy of 1,000 days with 966. Damn you, Rose, but not really, that win was sick. With the strawweight division crowning a champion at the finale of the Ultimate Fighter 20, many thought that after Carla Esparza's win, she'd be sat on the strawweight throne for a lot longer than just 92 days. However, Polish striker Joanna Jędrzejczyk would obliterate Esparza in her first title defense, and it was clear that this division was just getting started. Joanna would go on to collect 5 title defenses against the best that the division had to offer from June 20th, 2015, May 13th, 2017, and then karma finally caught up with her. Number 9, Ronda Rousey, 1,074 days. Up next is everyone's new favorite WWE superstar, Ronda Rousey, who just clocked in at over 1,000 days at 1,074. So,
after
the point of Dana White proclaiming something wouldn't ever happen,
that nigga scared the fuck out of me.
Ronda Rousey was gifted the inaugural bantamweight belt at a pre-fight presser at UFC on Fox 5, Henson vs. Diaz in Washington. It makes a lot of sense, I guess. She went on to defend the belt against Uriah Faber, Misha Tate, Sarah McMahon, Alexis Davis, Katsin Gala, and finally everyone's favorite Brazilian, Betch Correa. A solid 2-year, 6 title defense run. This, of course, all came crashing down in spectacular fashion when Holly Holm booted her in the face and told her never to return. But she did listen, did she? Number 8, Dominic Cruz, 1,117 days. Limping his way into number 8 is none other than the inaugural bantamweight division champion and my favorite fighter turn analyst journalist Dominic Cruz, who checks in with 1,117 days on the clock. After closing out the WEC bantamweight division with his second title defense of the WEC belt, Cruz in turn would win the inaugural UFC bantamweight belt, and with his 8th straight win, UFC fans who were unaware of Dominic Cruz were in for a treat. He wrapped up 2 impressive wins over Liz Carmouche and flyweight champion Demetrius Johnson, and after coaching the Ultimate Fighter 15, expected to face Faber for a 3rd time. Cruz, however, would go injured from May 7th, 2012 to January 6th, 2014 with a torn ACL, and then later a torn groin, and vacated the belt. Cruz sits as the only champion on this list to have less than 3 title defenses. Number 7, Daniel Cormier, 1,162 days. Champ Champ 2, return of the heavyweight, Daniel Cormier punches his way into number 7 of the list with 1,162 days as light heavyweight champion. With Jones out being an absolute mess, Daniel Cormier's time finally came with a big win over Anthony Rumble Johnson at UFC 187, defending it twice against Gus and Johnson again, until finally losing it back to Jones at UFC 214. But, plot twist, with Jones popping for Terrell, the fight was overturned to a no contest and Cormier was reinstated as undisputed champion. Therefore, his days as champion would continue as if nothing happened. It's pretty much like every UFC promo now that follows his history. Cormier would again defend the title once more against Volkan Ozdemir and currently holds 3 title defenses to his name. Number 6, Tito Ortiz, 1,260 days. The Huntington Beach fanboy Tito Ortiz is in at number 6. Don't worry, Tito, we didn't forget about you. I know you are worrying about that at the moment. He wrestled down 1,260 days as light heavyweight champion. Other than being known for beating the shit out of Ken Shamrock a handful of times, Tito Ortiz actually held the UFC light heavyweight title from April 14th, 2017. 44 where he would take a look spanking and close up his 5-title defense run. Number 5, John Jones, 1,501 days. John Bones Jones snorts his way over the 1,500 mark as over his titanic reign of the light heavyweight division, he clocks in at 1,501 days. After John Jones wrecked Mauricio Shogun Hood to become the youngest UFC champion ever, it was pretty clear that MMA was transitioning into a new age of mixed martial arts, and John Jones was the epitome of it. He would go on to defend against a string of fighting legends like Roundhouse Jackson, Rashida, Evans, and Belfort, ultimately racking up a dominant 8 title defenses. This, of course, would all come crashing down after his involvement with a hit and run that lost him the title and a 6-year of doping violations thereafter.
That the molded, like, all right.
Despite many sleepless nights and through the
I'm saying this is A, to thank you just after our year anniversary, but also B, because of the very first video. Talking UFC title wins, it's hard to think of anything other than the epic runs the likes of Anderson Silva, George St. Pierre, John Jones, and more recently Demetrius Johnson, providing the fans with some of the most iconic moments that the UFC has to offer, and the sheer amount of days they accumulated as champions. So what about the champions that didn't exactly accumulate a lengthy title reign, that became champion, perhaps immediately suited up to defend the belt, and lost? I'm Tom from MMA on Point, just me, and this is 10 shortest UFC title reigns. Number 10, Henan Barão, 138 days. Back in 2010, when Dana White announced the WEC would merge with the UFC and Dominic Cruz would be promoted to the UFC Bantamweight Champion, many thought after a couple of big wins over Uriah Faber and inaugural UFC Flyweight Champion Demetrius Johnson, that Cruz would go on to have similar success as the champions mentioned in the intro. However, on May 7th, when Cruz declared that he had torn his ACL and had undergone surgery, the interim title was created, which Henan Barão would win against Uriah Faber at UFC 149. Despite going on to defend this interim bantamweight title against Michael McDonald and Eddie Wineland from mid-2012, Barão's undisputed reign would only begin on January 6, 2014, after a title unification fight with Cruz fell through and Cruz suffered a groin tear, having to vacate the title. So Barão would go on to defend this title once against Uriah Faber, taking his winning streak to 22 before losing the undisputed title to TJ Dillashaw in spectacular fashion. And according to the history books, despite the interim run, his undisputed